Hello everyone. I've come to have a look at this old watermill, or the remnants of it. And there's been a mill here since the about 1560, I think, but the first actual records of there being a mill, 1650s, and the upper mill was rebuilt in the 18th century. Not sure the exact date, but I've seen a picture of it, a sketch of it on the internet. It's Hedgecourt Mill. And also there's a photograph of the wooden cogs and workings of inside the mill. And this is all that's left, is the ironwork, or some of it. Most of the wood's rotted away. It is on private land, so you can't just turn up here and explore it without permission. I would like to add that, but it is a lovely, it's a lovely old mill house. So it used to be two houses, and it's been converted into one. But the mill was driven by the water overflow from the pipe up there. So it's driven from the top, not from a river below, so from the lake. And this is all dammed and the valley flooded. And that's the cogwheel, or what, I don't know what the official term for it is, but that's the one that drove the upright sort of differential gearing, the cog that was upright, drove an upright that twisted the millstones. Were like 8 foot diameter on the first floor. On the other side of this wall, there's the remnants of the old water wheel, and all that's left is the 8 spars of the, and the central. Yeah, all that's left is the 8 iron, cast iron spars that went out to the wooden section of the wheel, which is all rotted away. But there's still some of the central part of it. You can see that where the woods must have been a huge fig tree for it to still be visible in the water. But it's a beautiful little spot. Apart from the aircraft, keep coming over. The part of the mill was built out of stone, which there's 2 blocks there to the left, which is a couple of bits that are visible. And quite a lot of brickwork. But the upper part of the mill was wooden, framed with wooden shuttering. Apparently at one time it was brick and tile, I should put a link up to the history of it. And that big oak you can see behind the wheel, behind the wall, that is in the sketch. And I believe there's part of the history was writing about how the roots of the oak have got into the brickwork and slowly sort of tearing the brickwork apart, but I haven't been over the other side yet, but that tree looks like it's recently been cut down from the top. All those blocks, wooden blocks on the left. Going by the size of it, I'd say that was here as long as the mill's been here. Not that I'm an expert dendrologist. It's an eight-sided drive shaft made from oak. See how big that must have been. You can see still parts of it rotted away down there. Still some wood inside that central shaft. Still just about make out the old rotten wooden oak drive shaft. Sorry if I'm getting the terminology wrong, but I'm not an expert. In fact, thinking about it, the drive shaft would have been the upright one, that would have been the axle between the two wheels. Yeah. Let's take a look at the other wheel. I guess this is the way up. First floor says it was up at ground level, so there's a few steps going down, so there must have been three floors. The wheel well below both sides, and the ground floor, and then the first floor. Let's see how it goes. Through the holly, through the prickly holly. See those old bits of stonework on the end of the brickwork there. Just come through this. I don't know how safe that central wall is. I don't want to destroy any of it any more than it is already. These steps up. I wonder how many millwrights, how many times a millwright and the miller walked up and down these. apparently back in the day they never got paid in money, they got paid in grain, and then I guess they sold their share on to the bakers or whoever, or flour or grain. What is that? Yeah, 1, 2, 3, 4. Yeah, there'd have been 8 spindles, spokes. If you look into the water, see the axle, the old oak axle, still rotting away. The water would have turned this from above, it would have had lots of wood on it, so as to catch the flow of the water, it would have rotated forward, the water would have gone off into the stream down to the wire mill, I think it was called, a mile or so from here. And the water flows from Furnace Wood into this Hedgecourt Lake, which is out here. Some more stonework there on top of the brick. On the left. Just make out a couple of those spokes on the drive wheel. I wonder how old this mighty oak was. Might be an easy job to count those rings and that. And that's not even the thickest part. That comes from there, I should think. This one. All been chopped down. Well, the lady's just told me that she wants to let her dogs out. I said, I don't mind. She said, no, they won't stop barking if you could wrap it up soon. So that's what I'll do. up on the surface. Quick, get some crust out.
Thank you.
And that's your sluice gate. That pipe goes under that road and that lets your water through to the top of the watermill for the overflowing water pressure. Baby ducks, some big baby ducks. Oh, one step. Guess that was last used in about 1920 when the mill was last used. Shame about that bloody aircraft. The actual gate's missing. Flew away into the holly bush. I saved a life today. Feels good to be a lifesaver. Albeit just a dragonfly. Spider was a bit slow. Must be asleep. Clicking was, I thought it was somebody walking along with a walking stick. It's a duck clicking. What's it about? That's a grebe, a couple of coots, a couple of gulls, terns, skimming the surface. It's pretty agile. Black-headed gull. Two coots left of that white ball boy, and two grebes beyond that fit, up of that fish's fin swimming across there. There's two carp swimming to the right, and beyond that is two grebes. Crested grebe. And those ducks down here, still just chilling. Siesta.
First thing they see that moves is that's the... Yeah.